Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today we will be speaking about separating of mixtures. So when we talk about matter, we can classify it. The first thing is it uniform throughout? If yes, then it is homogeneous. Otherwise, it is heterogeneous. If it is homogeneous, then the question arises, can it be separated by physical methods that easily is separated? If it is yes, then it is homogeneous mixture, and if it is no, it is a pure substance. Now, what is a pure substance? If any object can be decomposed further, then it is a compound, otherwise it is an element. So, now to give you the definition of each, if we say the matter is classified into your pure substance and impure substance, pure substances which contain single type of particles, whereas impure does not contain single type of particles. Pure substance can be classified as element and compound. Element has single type of particles, whereas compounds have different types of particles in a fixed ratio bonded by chemical bonds. Now to separate one solid from another solid, the first technique we have is threshing. Threshing is separation of chaff from the grain. So we have the grains which are being beaten. They are wet on a surface to separate the chaff from the grain. Then we have winnowing, which separates heavier and lighter component of a mixture by wind. Okay, so we have these grains which are just lifted on in the wind, so that whatever is the husk which is present is separated off, and the grains, you can get the grains out of it. So that is known as winnowing. Then we have hand picking. You would have seen in a house from the rice, they will just pick up the stones and throw it away. That is hand picking. Then we have sieving. Sieving is by using a sieve which have got small holes, there is a separation of fine particles. Then we have magnetizing, wherein we separate the magnetic material like iron filings from a mixture. The iron ore, the powdered iron ore is allowed to move through a conveyor belt, and the magnetic roller is there which separates the iron ore. Now we have another separation, method of separation, which is evaporation and condensation. Okay, so now what is evaporation? Evaporation is the water gets evaporated, leaving down whatever are the residuants. Okay, the sediments are there. So the best example is how salt is evaporated. The sea, the bunds are made, seawater is allowed to evaporate, you get salt. Then we have condensation. The vapor is allowed to cool down. That is condensation. Say you have a salt water. You allow it to evaporate and then cool down, so that salt will get deposited and you will get the water out of it. Then if you want to separate solids from the liquids, then you have various techniques. The first one is sedimentation. You let the mixture stand for some time, like muddy water. You let it stand for some time, the mud will settle down. Next is decantation. You put the clear water outside, that is decantation. Then you have filtration. If you use a filter paper and you pour the muddy water, you will see all the residues will be there and you will get the filtrate. Okay, so whatever is a pure liquid, you will get it. So that is filtration. Next, you can have loading. This is to speed up the separation process. You will add an alum to the muddy water so that the mud gets separated very easily. Next, we are coming to liquid in liquid separation, like oil and water. So they have got a different density. You can let them settle in a separating funnel, and there is a stopcock which you can open and let the liquid. The next is centrifugation. So the best example how what is being separated by centrifugation is blood. So the blood is taken and then it is allowed to rotate at a very high speed. So thus the plasma, the RBCs, WBCs, everything gets separated. You know the components of blood. The next one is churning. Churning is how you separate out the butter from the milk. So that is churning. So you know the very famous, we know Lord Krishna loves butter. So that is the churning had taken place. Next, while separating which are miscible or non-miscible in water. So you can have a sawdust and sand. You allow them to settle in the water for some time. You will see the sawdust will float, whereas sand will settle down. Thus, you can separate them. This is majorly used for separating plastics for plastic recycling machines and all those things. So, the next kind of separation is sublimation. Sublimation means the solid converts directly into gas. So, we know one of the major sublimate is camphor. So, camphor is allowed to heat, and then there is an inverted funnel where camphor gets settled in the solid form. So that is sublimation. So then you can extract the camphor out of the mixture of camphor and sand, say, maybe. Okay. So thank you. That is it for the separation of components. Thank you.